If you are thinking about investing in the Cleveland area, folks, do not spend your money until you talk to me first. I got a client who's looking at possibly doing a Brrrr deal on this one. But what I do, folks, is I let you know about the deals you should do and the deals you shouldn't do, right? Think about that. Most realtors you talk to, they only get paid one way, when you close the sale. Don't ask your barber if you need a haircut, man. Don't ask the pizza delivery guy if you're hungry, okay? You need to get open, honest, unbiased feedback. That's what I do. Let's take a look at this deal and help out my client. This is your show. This is the show where I work for you directly, taking your needs. I'm going through the MLS, and I'm trying to find the best possible deal for you guys. Put down 25%. That's the perfect way to buy this. That's why real estate investing is the greatest industry in the world. Welcome to the show. My name is James Wise, and I work for people like you. Today's client is my guy, Mark. He's an investor from Minneapolis, and he sent this to me. He's interested in doing a Brrrr deal on this one, Mark. This property, it's in Cleveland Heights, all right? 1856 Lee Road, Cleveland Heights, 44118, priced at $123,900, was on the market for 97 days. Currently, they took it off the market, right? You are considering doing a Brrrr deal on this one, and it is definitely jacked, okay? This thing needs a full-on renovation, okay? Everything that could be screwed up with this particular property is screwed up, okay? Just going off of the photos, like of all the damage that I see here, I feel like this is probably going to be like, I don't know, interior, 50 grand, okay? 50 grand to put it together on the inside. In addition, you see this? I stopped right here. It's where the garage should be. This is Cleveland Heights. Cleveland Heights has what's called a point of sale. Okay, I have more information on that in the notes below. But essentially, they issue violations, and the buyer needs to either assume those violations or the seller needs to clear them. Now, when you're the buyer and you're assuming violations, you need to put money in escrow, right? They have not. These sellers didn't even go through the process of getting the POS done yet. Sometimes you get unsophisticated sellers that don't know what's going on. They don't realize that they need to do this stuff. They list them. But you can't transfer title until the POS is done and either the seller clears everything or the buyer agrees to assume them. Now, one thing that's going to pop up on that POS is the fact that there's a garage no longer present. They're going to make you do a garage, okay? That's probably another 20 grand, maybe 25, honestly, if they make you do a brick one to match the house. So now you're looking at about 75K in repairs. And then outside, they may mess with you on some of this concrete. They usually do. So in my opinion, once you factor in the interior as well as the exterior POS issues, you might be as high as like $90,000 on this sucker. But it gets worse. In addition to that, what you need to understand is you have to put money in escrow to clear the POS, right? So if it's like they want you to escrow 90K, you got to put a separate 90K in escrow. Then you spend a different 90K to clear the escrow, and then they'll release it, okay? If the deal's got meat on the bone, fine, cool. Those are the rules. We could play by those rules. No big deal. But here, not really, dude. They're trying to get 123, and maybe you need $90,000, right? So you're all in at like 2.25, but the seller, it's like a goofy seller. You have to actually go to like some goofy website. It's like one of these, I don't even know, they're selling like bank-owned houses. You have to actually go to like some goofy website, and you have to actually pay a fee just to submit your bid. It's like a $200 fee just to submit your bid. The agent that's working with this seller, their relationship appears to have deteriorated to where they're no longer considering working together. They pulled it off the market. This isn't like something that's simple and easy where you can just like talk to an actual physical person, right? There's just going to be a bunch of red tape, a bunch of bureaucracy. We don't have a POS that's even done, and I know it's going to be at least a 90K rehab. Paying $123,000 wouldn't make any sense from a financial standpoint for you. You need to get this price down like 50, 60 grand, but like you got to go through all these hoops, and Like, if we're looking at, like, probability of you putting together a deal that actually makes sense for you, financially speaking, for, like, the probability of you getting that done, dude, it's probably, like, a 1 in 100 shot. So for this one, there's just, like, so many things stacked against you. I would just move on. This one, yes, it needs repairs, but this ain't a deal. And, again, it ain't even for sale anymore because the seller pulled it off the market, and they're not working well with their seller, and... this ain't a deal, brother. This one, we're moving on.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to HoltonWise TV for more financial information, education, and entertainment.